Hey guys, Steven here back with another video, and today I'll be teaching you 5 video transition effects that you can use in your videos, whether that's vlogs or music videos or documentaries or skits. Transitions can really help you out. It makes the video, you know, seem more seamless, more professional, more effortless. I try to steer away from any very overused, you know, effects like, you know, the Luma key fade or the smooth zoom transition that you see in a lot of travel videos. These are ones that are very simple, very easy to achieve so that you can, you know, do this without any plugins, without any effort, and you don't really have to think about it. But if you do want to know some of the overused, you know, transitions, there are a couple links in the description to some videos I made in the past. And there's also 15 different effects that you can use in your music videos and your vlogs and all that sort of stuff in the description as well if you want to check that out. If you do enjoy this video, hit the thumbs up button and let's just get started. So the first transition I have is actually a variation of a very popular music video effect. I made an entire video on the strobe light effect, you know, like a week ago, and I left out this very variation on purpose because I think it really suits your videos better as a transition than an actual effect. So how you accomplish this is you want to duplicate this layer or whatever clip you're using. I always say layer because I'm used to Photoshop, but you want to hold Alt and drag up. This will duplicate the layer. You can obviously copy and paste if you want. You want to now set the opacity as 50 or 40 or something less than 100, depending on how visible you want to make it. Now you want to speed up the clip. So right click, go to speed and duration, set it as like 700, 800, something really fast. And now you want to move it to the very end so that it lines up with this end as well. If you want to, you know, use the middle, you can just cut out the middle and put it in the middle. But I think it looks better at the end because by putting it at the end, it can lead into another clip and it can act as a transition. Some people don't like that, and some people prefer to use, you know, the basic strobe effect where it just flashes black in between, but I think it looks better this way. So where the flicker part comes in is you want to now cut this layer at the top right here. So you want to cut every single frame, and then what you want to do after you do this is you want to delete every other frame so it flickers. That's kind of the strobe effect that I mentioned. So just delete every other layer or every other clip, sorry, my bad, and then press play. And then there you go. That's a really nice transition. It looks much better if the next clip is something that's in the same environment. So let me show you what I mean. So let's just move it right here. Another thing that can make it look even better is if you want to make a better transition out of this, you want to move the second layer under the part where it flickers. So if you just press play right here, this makes it even more seamless because the clips at the top right here are actually clips of the previous clip, but just less visible, right? So you can kind of still see it. And then when it flickers out of that and then back into the second clip. So just press play. You can barely tell, right? That looks just, that's just super, super cool. Like that's just, you know, cool, you know? So for the second transition, this is probably the simplest transition that I've come up with. And I kind of got inspiration from this from Justin Escalona, who runs Play the Game Films. He does this a lot in his vlogs, or at least his older vlogs, where basically it's a clip of him, you know, vlogging and stuff, and then it speeds up into the other clip. It's very simple. So basically all you do is you take a portion of the clip so you can see how long that is. Probably like, I don't know, not that long. You just want to cut. So towards the end right here, you just want to speed it up. Let's just say 500. And then that's it. So basically at this point, it speeds up and then just goes into the new clip. That's it. And what makes it better is if you add additive dissolve, which is a video transition, and basically it flashes. It's better if it's a smaller like length. And I kind of got inspiration from this by doing music videos and stuff. Basically, that's it. You can't really see it at all, actually. Let's make this a bit longer like that. Something like that. It's just super quick. So it goes at normal pace. It speeds up into the other clip. So I'm going to show you how this is going to look like if they're in the same sort of environment like I showed in the first transition. So let's see. Let's just delete this part. Delete, delete. And let's just speed up this. You can also do this in between takes. So I actually have a video here that I made. Let's just move right here. So at this one point, I actually did the same exact thing, but it wasn't acting as a transition. It was just speeding up and then going at normal speed. So right here. So you saw right there. Actually, this was sort of a transition. So at this point right here, it speeds up and then goes into the next clip. So you can see that's really effective. So let's try it right here. So let's just speed up this part. Let's see, like 500 as well. So you can see there. So yeah, that's it for this transition. The next transition's literally a transition that you can, you know, just move right here. So it's called non-additive dissolve. It's my favorite, you know, built-in transition that you don't have to do anything with. You can just apply it. You can see right here. It's just very simple. So you can see bits and pieces of the next clip, and then out of nowhere, it disappears, right? It's kind of similar to Luma fade, but it isn't really a fade. It just happens all at once. It's basically the opposite of additive dissolve, where it flashes first. So let's see, and that's it. And this is just so funny to me. Just look at this. Whatever. Let's just delete that. The fourth transition is also very similar. It's just blur. It's just Gaussian blur. You can also use motion blur, but I prefer Gaussian blur, to be honest. So you want to go to your project right here. You want to make a new adjustment layer, and then you just want to place it over here. And then delete this, and then just place it right in the middle right here between these two clips. I'm gonna show you how it looks like with Gaussian or Gaussian. People never remind me about that. It's Gaussian, I think. And then you want to either go to Gaussian blur or any other blur, actually. So let's just go to Gaussian. That just sounds weird. Gaussian. You just want to place it. You want to set the blurriness. So you just go in the middle right here. Go like somewhere right here. Set the blurriness however much you want. Press repeat edges, or else there's going to be like a shadow on the corners right here. And then you want to set a keyframe at that point. Go to the beginning. Set it as 0. Go to the end. Set it as 0. And then let's just find the middle right here. Where's the middle? Like somewhere right here. You want to move it down here. So basically what this will do is it starts at 0 blurriness, it goes into blurriness, and then it fades back out to blurriness. It looks better if it's very quick, but sometimes in like documentaries or very like raw videos, it might look really, really nice because it'll be like a soft, glowy transition. So this might actually look good in here. So let's just press play. Maybe if it was quicker, let's click on this. Let's make it a little bit quicker. If it was a more fast-paced video, it might also look good. So like that, that might look pretty good. And I'll show you with motion blur. It looks a bit different, not so much different. Or it's called directional blur, actually. So let's drag it, delete this. Let's press here, go here, here, here. Just set all the keyframes first, so you know. So here, here. So sort of like that. Let's delete these. And let me show you how it looks like with directional blur. So directional blur, you want to start off at 0. And then in the middle right here, you want to change the direction. So there's actually the direction of the blur, so you can change it up. So I'll just do it 90 degrees, and then make the blur length a little bit bigger, maybe like something like that. And basically it's more impactful. It's more strong. It's a little bit flashier, you know? And yeah, that's basically it for the transition right there. Finally, for the last transition, I call it the crop zoom transition. I'm making up names and stuff now. But I haven't seen anybody do this. It's probably a thing. It's very simple. But basically all you do is you make 4 cuts into these two clips. So at the end and the start of these, so you can see the end of this clip, the start of this clip, pretty self-explanatory. And basically you just change the scale. So set this one as 150, set the next one as 125, so it's getting gradually smaller, and then set this as 150. So this is zooming in now. So this was like in, this is even more in, and then this one would be 100. So it acts as a really cool transition. So if you press play, so I think this would be really cool with vlogs just because of the nature of it, but like it kind of puts you into, you know, the next frame, you know? Just like, it just pushes you. Just like, it's like, I don't want to be here. Like, just look at my face. I don't want to be there. Like, see that? It pushes you into the next frame. That's really cool. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully it helped you out. If it did, hit the thumbs up button. Check out all the videos in the description if you want that. My name is Steven, and I'll see you in the next one.